Hello everyone, I'm Shalini Singh, Assistant Professor in Department of Commerce at GEMS Engineering Management Technical Campus, Greater Noida. In this lecture series of computerized accounting software, we are going to discuss about the ledgers and the group of ledgers under which the categorization is done. This is a lecture 4 of Unit 4. So let's begin. What is ledger and why it is defined as a principal work of accounts? In a journal, which is called as a memorandum book to record the transactions date-wise, on a particular date, what are the total purchases, total sales, debtors, creditors, income, expenses, that may be known as a journal. And to get that information about the same, the entries passed in the journal are classified on the basis of their nature in the another book, which is known as the ledger. So an account represents a detailed record of changes that have occurred in a particular asset, liability, expense, loss, gain, or capital during the accounting period. All these separate accounts are kept in a loose leaf binder, and the entire group of accounts is called as the ledger. So groups or a heading in tally, groups or ledgers heading in tally helps the tally to determine the type of ledger, whether the ledger account is affecting the income side, or is its nature that of an expense, or is it in an item which will give benefits or returns to business such as assets, or is it an item which increases a liability for the business which has to be settled now. So basically when all the transactions which are being passed, to separate those transactions, different accounts are being made. So defining their nature, the different ledgers or groups of ledgers are being categorized. What is the utility of a ledger? A ledger is the master record of all the accounts of a business unit. It is a principal book of double entry system of accounting which provides all the important information. Separate accounts are maintained based on their nature, so all the information relating to the transactions may be obtained through ledger, such as to whom what is payable, from whom what is receivable, what is the position of assets and liability of a business. Ledgers help us to prepare the trial balance to ensure the arithmetical accuracy of the accounts. Moreover, ledger assists us in preparing trading profit and loss account and balance sheet. Why is grouping so important at ledger creation in Tally ERP? Grouping or heading in Tally helps the Tally to determine the type of ledger, whether the ledger account is affecting the income side or is its nature that of expense. So it becomes necessary to put the ledger in correct head or group so that the Tally can account it properly. In Tally, grouping is basically done to define the categorization of particular group, whether it is of expense category or of income category. So instead of creating single ledger, we have to create the groups, and creation under different groups is very important. So these are the list of ledgers which are categorized accordingly when we prepare a ledger. So ledger name is purchase return. When we prepare a purchase return ledger, it is categorized, the tally head is purchase and the ledger is purchase return. Purchase ledger is prepared, it is categorized under purchase. Sales return is categorized under sales, and sales is also categorized under sales. So whenever we prepare or create ledgers in the different names, they are categorized accordingly depending upon the type of or nature of that particular transaction. So carriage, it is a direct expense, it is categorized under direct expense. Factory lighting, it is also carried under direct expenses. Freight and cartage, defined under direct expenses. Import duties also categorized under direct expenses. Import duty, rent, royalty, wages, these all are created under the direct expenses ledger. We can create single ledgers also, and if we know, we can group them under direct expenses head and maintain a group of ledgers together. Then profit and loss account, the expenses or losses, and expenses or incomes or profit and losses are categorized accordingly. Advertisement is categorized under indirect expense. Bank charges, indirect. Bill is drawn, bill drawn, indirect. Carriage, indirect. Commission allowed is indirect. Then discount allowed is also indirect. Donation, charity, indirect. Free sample, indirect. Insurance premium, indirect. Interest on loan, legal charge, loss by fire. These are all under indirect expenses. Bad debtors recovered, indirect. Commission received is also indirect. These are indirect incomes actually. Discount received, indirect income. Interest on drawings, indirect. Interest on investment and depreciation. Depreciation is an indirect expense. Interest on investment is an indirect income. So the categorization of indirect income expenses are done under the profit and loss head. And whenever the creation is being done, it can be created in a group also, but most probably we prefer to make them in a single ledger. Expenses, office lighting, indirect, petty cash, indirect, postage and courier, indirect, printing, stationery, indirect, rent, indirect, repair charges, indirect, salary, indirect, sales, depreciation, indirect, taxi fare, indirect, telephone charges, indirect, trade, traveling and suspense. All these are categorized under the head indirect expenses. So that's all for today. This is why we perform the grouping of ledgers, so that whenever a ledger creation is being done, it has to be categorized accordingly, so that whenever we perform the entries, it is easier for us to locate them according to the nature of the particular ledger. Thank you.